हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, सो नेक्स्ट फंक्शंस ऑफ मैनेजमेंट। सो द डेफिनेशन ऑफ मैनेजमेंट वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड दैट। सो मैनेजमेंट इज द प्रोसेस, ओके, मैनेजमेंट इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ गेटिंग थिंग्स डन थ्रू अदर्स। सो इन द वर्ड प्रोसेस, इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ द स्टेप बाय स्टेप एक्टिविटीज, दैट स्टेप बाय स्टेप एक्टिविटीज ओनली कॉल्ड एज फंक्शंस ऑफ मैनेजमेंट। Okay, so in that functions, the very first one is planning. You take any organization, so every management, first it has to focus on planning. So planning means what then? In simple words, planning is nothing but a deciding future course of action in advance. Before taking decision, we supposed to think about that and we supposed to make a proper plan, and then only we can reach a particular destination. So it is nothing but taking or deciding the future course of action in advance. Otherwise, we also call or we also can come to know what is planning by answering the questions like what is to be done, what is to be done, and where it is to be done. Who has to do it and how it has to be done. So just we need to find the answers for these questions, and thereby we can achieve the organizational goals. Or otherwise, planning is such a concept where it bridges the gap between where we are and where we want to go. That is the destination. Okay, so it is something acts as a bridge which fills the gap between where we are and where we want to go. Okay, so in order to reach our destination, we supposed to go in particular path, and deciding that particular path in advance is called as planning. Okay, so the success of your plan always depends on the accuracy of your prediction, because always plan is based on your predictions. So if your predictions are good, your plan definitely going to get success. Okay, so once you are going to plan means, so it is not going to give you any assurance of any guarantee of success. Okay, it doesn't mean that once you plan planning you are not going to get any problems. Planning predict, you can predict the problem only, you cannot pretend the problem, but you can predict the problem, and thereby you can prepare yourself to face whatever kind of challenges. Okay, that's about the planning. And then the other thing, that is the next function, is organizing. So once after planning, the second function of management is organizing. So organizing is also called as plan of action, which means once you have planned, you are supposed to give a practical shape to your plan. So you are supposed to give a practical shape. So that's what, that giving practical shape is nothing but organizing. Okay, it is going to deal with arranging resources. Organizing is nothing but arranging the required resources just in order to establish your plan. It is just the implementation process. It is taking initiation of that plan. Okay, that is what organizing is. Okay, and also organizing involves creation of authority and responsibility. Or you need to delegate the authority and responsibility. You need to make some number of departments. You supposed to give them some sort of work. Okay, you supposed to give them some sort of authority and responsibility, and thereby you're supposed to get the work done. Okay, so organizing is concerned with implementation of plan or giving actual shape to your imagination. Okay, so where in that process usually you are going to relate to the task of assigning or delegating the authorities and responsibilities, and making so many number of departments and assigning authority and responsibility and all. Okay, that is about the organizing. So once planning is over and organizing is over, the next function of management is स्टाफिंग, स्टाफिंग इज नथिंग बट हायरिंग द पर्सन्स, हायरिंग द पीपल आर पुटिंग पीपल ऑन जॉब. यूजुअली आर इन सिंपल वर्ड्स इट इज कॉल्ड एज इट इज टर्म्ड एज putting people on job, which means in order to get the work done, so you supposed to fill each places with a suitable candidates. So that is what staffing is, nothing but putting right people in the right places at the right time. Okay, so right people, you need to search for right people. Okay, and you supposed to keep them in right place, and that too at right time. Right time. Okay, so you supposed to keep these points in your mind. Okay, so staffing is nothing but putting right people in the right places at the right time, or putting people on job. So you supposed to go for recruitment. So it contains some other activities like recruitment. Recruitment, selection, okay, recruitment, selection, and training, promotion, okay, such kind of activities. Which means recruitment is nothing but, so you supposed to search for prospective employees. You need a certain qualification, so you supposed to find such people, and you supposed to give some ads in different medias, and thereby you supposed to work. Work on searching for the prospective employee, and then whatever the applications you will get, so you are supposed to screen them, and you are supposed to select the best candidate among the applicants, and then you are supposed to, if it is necessary, you are supposed to provide them some training facility where you are going to make them convenient to the jobs, and then you are supposed to give them promotion, and that all activities involved in the staffing. Okay, in simple words, it is nothing but maintaining a satisfied and satisfactory workforce in the organization. Because whatever the technology you will be having, so unless you don't have right kind of people to operate those, so it is nothing. So that is why you need to maintain a satisfied workforce in the organization. And staffing is related to that. The next one. The fourth function of our management is directing. In simple words, it is nothing but guiding the people. Okay, so directing is always concerned with leading, influencing, and motivating the people. You keep motivate them, because you are supposed to provide such a environment where people are going to work with satisfaction. If suppose somebody are doing mistakes, you supposed to monitor them, you supposed to observe, and you supposed to give them proper direction, and so that you can take them to the achievement of organizational goals. Okay, so directing is nothing but observing, guiding, and motivating the people, so that you can take them to the desired results, desired destinations. Okay, in simple words, it is nothing but providing proper guidance to the employee to get the work done in a proper manner. Okay, then the last function of management, that is controlling. So it also plays an important role in the management. So once you have planned, fine, you have organized the proper resources, and you have put the right people on the right places, and then you are going to direct them. But yet you are supposed to monitor the work time to time, whether your work is going in a proper manner or not. Okay, so that you are supposed to keep some observation, and if you find any deviation is taking place, you are supposed to correct that. Okay, it is nothing but taking corrective actions, timely actions, and so that you are going to achieve the organizational goals effectively. Okay, so which means this particular controlling process contains the steps like you supposed to set standard works, and then you supposed to measure the actual performance, and then you supposed to compare actual with the standards, and if you find any deviations, you supposed to take corrective actions. Means if you have created some standards. You wanted to achieve something, okay, and you wanted to be at the particular space, that's the particular achievement at a particular time, and timely you are supposed to measure whether timely you are going to achieve that or not. For example, if your organization in a management, you have decided to produce some 10,000 units in a month. 10,000 units in a month. You have planned to produce 10,000 units in a month. So standard is every 10 days, every 10 days at least 3,300 units to be produced in order to get the work done. 10,000 units in a month means at least 3,300 per 10 days. Okay, so you supposed to keep watching whether after every 10 days we are achieving this sub target or not. If you are unable to achieve this, so you supposed to make some corrective actions. Okay, it is nothing but comparing the standard with the actual performance and taking corrective actions if any deviations there. Okay, that is about the control. Okay, so that is about the functions of management. Okay, so in any management, always work starts with planning, and then that is followed by organizing, staffing, then presenting and controlling. Okay, so this particular steps are interrelated. So it is very difficult to say where one ends at which time and where one begins. You cannot specifically say where one ends and the other begins. These are interrelated activities. Okay, that is about the functions of management. In the next class, we will continue with the coordination topic. So till then, stay home, keep learning. Thank you.